Hilchis Kiddush Achedish Perek Shmini. Chotcha Shalavana, Tisha Ve'esim Yein U'mechza V'tov Shin Sadigimul Chalokim. K'mesha B'yan. The Achedish Shalavana, which means from one Melad to another Melad, is B'cheshmen Hemtzoi, is Choftes Yein, Yud Beishois, and Tov Shin Sadigimul Chalokim. V'yev Shalemar She'esh Achedish Yiyeb Miktzis Hayeh. You'll say, once you reach the end of the cycle, so now starts another month. At sheyeh miktsas hayeh mechedesh over umiktsasim yehaba shenamar at chedesh yomim. So from this pasuk we learn out in piashmu alamdu sheyom atemachashu lechedesh viatemachashu shoyes. So there has to be full days for a chedesh. You can't say that half a day is the past chedesh and the next half a day is from this chedesh. Lefichach. So if the Chodshi HaLevana Be'emes is not full days, it's not 30 full days, it's not 29 full days. So what do we do? Lefichach, Eisen Chodshi HaLevana Mehem Chedesh Chaser, Mehem Chedesh Mali. Chedesh Chaser means Tisha Ve'esem Yein Bilvat. Why is it called Chaser? Ve'aval Pisha Chodshi HaLevana is Yeser Al Zeh B'Shoyis. But nevertheless, the whole Chedesh is only 29 days. And it's not taking into account the extra 12 hours in Tovshin Tzadigim al-Chalokim. And v'chedesh shmoli m'shleishim yeim, v'aval pi shechotche shalavon apachzim yizeh b'shoiz, k'dei shalei l'chashev shoiz b'chedesh al-yom m'shleim. So in other words, since we want to count only days for a month, so a month is a cycle which is connected to the moon, and that cycle is a little bit, is less than 30 days. So some months are 29 days, and some months are 30 days. Halachi Gimel. Ilo haye chotche shalavana, tisha ve'esim yeimu mechze bulvad. So then things would be very glatik. Haye kol hashanim, chedesh mali v'chedesh chasim. So in other words, since there's 29 and a half days, so in 2 months you have 59 days. 59 days makes up 2 months. Chedesh mali v'chedesh chasim. V'hoyu yimei shnas halavana, shleish meis arboa v'chamishim, shisha chadosh m'chseirim. So in other words, you'd have 354 days every Shnas HaLevana, because 12 months is 6 months of 30 and 6 months of 54. Mele 354. Aval mipnei achalokim sheyesh b'chol chedesh v'chedesh yetzer al chatzi hayeim. In other words, the tashzag halokim, which is the 44 minutes plus a chelik, is yiskabitz mehem shoyiz v'yom. So Mela, so those gathered, after 2 months, you already have an hour and a half. And after 12 months, after maybe 15 months or whatever, you have 16 months, after 16 months, you have already a full day. And Mela, so that day has to be accounted for. Is that Shiyah? So Mela, you'll have to have an extra day. So how are you going to have an extra day? So instead of making 6 months, chaser 6 months mole, you'll have to have 7 months mole and 5 months chaser. So you'll have an extra mole that'll make up for that time. But the problem is when you can have an extra mole, so maybe make up, you'll have an extra twice mole. So you may make up, in other words, more than the time. So then you're going to have a chaser to accommodate for that. And that's how things go back and forth. In other words, in order for to adjust, if not for that tashzak halakim, so it would be able to be very simple. 354 days, in other words, it's always Mali and Chaser. Masha'inkin, since you have those extra Chalokim, and those extra Chalokim gather and they become a day, so then when you add a Chedesh Mali, an extra Chedesh Mali, so Mimele it comes out that you have too much time, so to speak. You have more than the Chedesh Shalavana, so then you have to diminish, and then you have an extra Chesedim, and that's how you, Gleichu is the Chesh, Nachamo. אבל פני החלוקים שיש בכל חדש וחדש יסר על חצי הים, זה יזכבס ממשויז ויום, עד שיהיו מיקסס השונים, חדושים חסרים יסר על מלאים. So you can end up having that the חדושים חסרים will be יסר על מלאים, which means that there'll be, let's say, 7 months of חסרים and 5 months of מלאים, as we'll learn. ומיקסס השונים, they'll be פקרת, חדושים מלאים יסר על חסרים, that there'll be 7 Malayim and 5 Chesedim. 5 Chesedim. And in an Ibra year, you could end up having 8 Malayim 8 Malayim and 5 Chseirim also, it's possible to have such Mitzvahs. Halacha Dalet. Yom Shloshim L'Oilam Oysim Oysi Rish Chedesh B'Cheshbon Zeh. We're saying there's months that have 29 days, months that have 30 days. The 30th day after the beginning of the month is always Rish Chedesh. Is Im Hoya Chedesh Aver Chaser. So knows the previous month only had 29 days. Is Yer Yom Shloshim Reisha Chedesh Abos. So the 30th day after the beginning of the previous month is the Rish Chedesh. And it begins the next month. But if this month, that this is the 30th day of a month, it's Tomar HaChedesh Mali, is Yer Yom Shloshim Rish Chedesh. It will also still have a din of Rish Chedesh. Hail Mitzosi Rish Chedesh, because this is already the pastors during this day of Rish Chedesh. That's when the Meiler is. And it'll also be the Tashlam of the Chedesh HaMoli Shavar. So notice, in dates, this is called the 30th of the previous month. But nevertheless, it's considered Rish Chedesh because it's the beginning of the next month. During this day is the beginning of the next month. And the year, Yem Echod Shleishim, Reish HaChedesh Abba, the proper Rish Chedesh, which is the Aleph, the Chedesh Abba, that's going to be the Yem Echod Shleishim. Umimenu, Hu Aminyan, Vuhu Yem Akvir. That's when things begin. Ulefichach Esim, Rashi Chadoshim Becheshbon Zer, Chedesh Echod Yem Echod Bul, Nachmo, Ulefichach Esim, Rashi Chadoshim Becheshbon Zer, Chedesh Echod Yem Echod Bulvad, Chedesh Echod Shnayom. So Bekitzur, you're telling me the Seder Rish Chedesh, that in other words, there's months which are Chaser, and there are months that are Mali. A month that's Chaser means a month that's 29 days. A month that's Mali is 30 days. Now, the 30th day after the beginning of the month is always Rish Chedesh. But if we're dealing with a Chedesh Malay, so first of all, it's also the 30th of the previous month, still part of the previous month, and it has a din of Rish Chedesh, because Lepil, that day, the pashtos, that's when the Meilad is. So Meilad, that's when it starts the Chedesh Abba. But Lepil, in date, it's not called Rish Chedesh. Rish Chedesh is, in other words, it's not called Chilus of the Chedesh Abba. It has a din of Rish Chedesh. But on the other hand, the Tchilas of Chedesh Abba is the following, the Yem Lamed Aleph. Masha'inkin, if the Chedesh was a Chedesh Chaser, so then the 30th day starts, that's Rish Chedesh, and that begins the Chedesh Abba. That's the deal. So when you have a Chedesh Molei, so then there's always the following, there's 2 days Rish Chedesh at the end of that Chedesh Molei. Because the 30th day is Rish Chedesh, and the first of the next month is also Rish Chedesh. Mashenkin, if you have a Chedesh Chaser, so the 30th is Rish Chedesh, and that's it. There's only one day Rish Chedesh. So that's the Seder Advar. So there's the Chedesh, there's a Chedesh Mole, and there's a Chedesh Chaser. And the Chedesh Mole has 2 days Rish Chedesh, and the Chedesh Chaser has 1 day Rish Chedesh. And why we have a Chedesh Mole and a Chedesh Chaser? Because of this Cheshman of the, that it's not, it's Choftes Yeim, Umechtse V'Tovshin Tzadigim Ul'Chalokim. So Mele, that's why you have to have a Chedesh Mali and a Chedesh Chaser. And why sometimes it's more Mali than Chaser, and sometimes more Chaser than Mali, is to accommodate for the Cheshmer of the Tovshin Tzadigim Ul'Chalok. Halacha Hei. Seder HaChadoshim HaMleim V'Chseidim L'Vi Cheshmer Zeh Kacho. The Rambam is going to tell you exactly how to make a calendar. When is the Chadoshim HaMleim and when is the Chadoshim HaChseidim? Is the Seder is Tishrei, is La'ela Mali. Tishrei is always Mali. And then he skips Cheshvan and Kislev, and he'll get back to it, because they're different. And V'chedesh Tevis is also Le'elam Chaser. Not always so. V'chedesh Tevis, Le'elam Chaser. U'mitevis Ve'elech is Echad Mali Ve'echad Chaser. Allah said, Ketzah. Tevis Chaser. So which means Shvat will always be 1 day Rish Chedesh. And Shvat Mali, which means other, will always be 2 days Rish Chedesh. And other Chaser, other will be chaser. This is the other asomach nissen will always be chaser. And nissen is mole. Ear chaser sivan mole. Tam is chaser of mole. Elul chaser. That's in a shana pshuta. Bishana muberes is other ishan is always mole. And the other sheni is chaser. Other is always chaser. So the regular other is the other sheni. That's the regular other. The other which was added was the other ishan. And that's you added a mole. You added a chedesh mole. So maybe it'll come out that there'll be, in other words, so Shvat will be Mali and other will be Mali together. Shvat is Mali, so Rosh Chodesh Adar Rishon will be Mali. Rosh Chodesh Adar Rishon will be two days Rosh Chodesh, and Alder of Zeh, Rosh Chodesh Adar Shein. Is Nisha, so these are the months that's the set. Abenisha Roshnei Chadoshim, Shehei Mar Cheshvan V'Kislev. And over these 2 months, is Pamim Yoshnei Mulayim, Upamim Yoshnei Mchseirim, Upamim Yemar Cheshvan Chasir V'Kislev Mali. This varies. You can have both of them Amali, you can have both of them Chasir, or you can have the Seder is that Mar Cheshvan is Chasir and Kislev is Mali. And Vishana Shiyu B'Shnei Chadoshim Eilu Mulayim, He shenikru chadoshei amaleim. Doesn't mean all the months. It means only these 2 months, chadoshei amaleim. V'sham v'shiyir v'shnei chadoshim eilu chseirim is nikru chadoshei chseirim. V'sham v'shiyir b'marchesh v'chasu v'kisri mole nikru chadoshei chseirim. So mele, we know the seder of the calendar, basically the cholesnik seder, that we know which months are always mole, which months are always chaser. And now there are 2 months which are sometimes both Mali, sometimes both Chaser, and sometimes one is Chaser and the other one's Mali. That would be Kisidon. So in other words, then it would be Tishrei is Mali, and Cheshvin Chaser, and Kislev Mali, and then Tevis again, Mali, Chaser. Halacha Zayin. Now Derech Yediyas Hashana, in Chadoshei Amaleim, Now you want to establish, you want to know what's going to be. Is it going to, the month's going to be Mulayim, Chseidim, or Kesidim? So you have to know. So just be close. Let's just be first. Because you have to know how many days this year has. How many days this year has. If you have a year which the Chadoshah is Kesidron, basically, it means there are going to be 6 months Mali, 6 months Chaser. So it comes out that there's 354 days in the year. If you're going to have a year which Chadoshei Chseirim, so Mele basically means that there's going to be 7 months Chseirim and 5 months Malayim. So Mele comes out that that year is going to have 353 days. You're going to have 353 days. There'll be 7 Chseirim. There's a push, 7 chseidim is 353 days. And if you have 7 malayim and 5 chseidim, so that's 355 days. So when you have a nachma l'shana pshuta, it could either be 353, 354, 355. If chadoshah kisidram is 354, is chseidim is 353. And if it's malayim, it's 355. Now how do you know how many days it has? That's a push to chashm. If you have the mailad, the Meulad of Tishrei of the year you're talking about, there's the Meulad of the Tishrei of that year. And then you have to find out what day is going to be Rosh Hashanah the following year. You have the Meulad of Tishrei of this year. I'm sorry, not the Meulad. You have the day of of Rosh Hashanah of that year. You know when Rosh Hashanah is that year, that you figured out the Rosh Hashanah of that year. And that we learned already in Perek Zayin. How do you figure out the Rosh Hashanah of the year? Whereas you have to find out when the Moilad of that Tishrei is. And based on when the Moilad is, that will establish when Rosh Hashanah is going to be with the whole of the Cheshbenis. In other words, Le'adureish, and if it's after Chatzes, it doesn't work out. All kinds of Cheshbenis, the four Cheshbenis. But Al Kopan, we figured out when Rosh Hashanah is of this year. We know when Rosh Hashanah is. And now we have to also know when Rosh Hashanah is next year. The following year, when is going to be Rosh Hashanah? So the following year, if we know when it's going to be Rosh Hashanah, how do we know when it's Rosh Hashanah? Because we know when the Moilad is. We know, the Rambam explained to us in Perek Vav, how we know when the Moilad of next Tishrei is going to be. That's, you figure out the Moilad. It's a very simple Cheshbon. Notice, if you know the Moilad of this year Tishrei, so you know the Moilad of next year Tishrei, because it's Dach Tatav. You know, it's 4 days, 8 hours, and tough Ayin Vav Chalokim. So Mameli, it's very simple to figure out the Moilad of Tishrei of next year. Once you know the Moilad of Tishrei next year, you also know the day of Rosh Hashanah next year. Now, once you establish the day of Rosh Hashanah next year, so you know the day of Rosh Hashanah of this year, and you know the day of Rosh Hashanah next year, now you have to figure out how many days are there going to be from this Rosh Hashanah to next Rosh Hashanah. So the Cheshbon is that if, Lamashal, if between, so the minimum amount of days that there could be between Rosh Hashanah and Rosh Hashanah, not including the 2 days Rosh Hashanah, is 2 days. Is 2 days. The maximum amount, now we're talking about now as far as the day of the week. The day of the week, the minimum amount, we're talking about Hashanah Pshuta. Hashanah Pshuta, the minimum amount of days between Rosh Hashanah and Rosh Hashanah, as far as days of the week are concerned, is 2 days. The maximum is 4 days. That's the maximum. We said, we discussed this before. Memela, it'll come out like this. If there are 2 days in between this day of Rosh Hashanah and the other day of Rosh Hashanah, and next Rosh Hashanah, 2 days, not including the 2 days Rosh Hashanah, so we know that that's the minimum. And Memela Chadoshech Seir, because there's only going to be 353 days in that year. There's going to be 353 days in that year. If on the other hand, there's going to be 3 days in between the two Rosh Hashanahs, so we know that Chadoshech Kesidron, because there's 354 days in that year. And if there's 4 days between the, so we know there's 355 days in the year, and then it's Chadoshech Melech. That's the Cheshbon, that's the Pashto Cheshbon. Now, the Cheshbon is Hazeit. It was 350 days is divided by seven. That's the days of seven. Now, you're coming now to the next year, Rosh Hashanah. So let's assume that Rosh Hashanah was on Thursday, was on Shabbos. Rosh Hashanah was on Shabbos. So it came out that when it came, there was 50 weeks of Rosh Hashanah. So when it comes Shabbos at the end of the year, the Shabbos at the end of the year is the 351st day. Because the Friday, that's when it ended the 350 days. That's when it ended the 7 of the weeks. The Shabbos, the new Shabbos again at the end of the year, that's the 351st day. So Shabbos is the 351st day. And Sunday is the 352nd day. And Monday is the 353rd day. Mele Lefiza, it comes out that, and then Tuesday is Rosh Hashanah. So there's 2 days, which is Sunday and Monday, between Shabbos and Tuesday. So Mele comes out that there are 353 days in that year. Masha'enkin, if let's say Rosh Hashanah was Thursday, and then the next year Rosh Hashanah was Monday. So it comes out that in between Thursday and Monday, there's Friday, Shabbos, and Sunday. So then we have 3 days. No, not 2 days, we have 3 days. So Mele comes out that the Thursday, in the 51st week, the Thursday, starts the 351st day, and then there's the 352nd day is Friday, and Shabbos is the 353rd day, and when it comes to Sunday, that's the 354th day, and Monday is already Rosh Hashanah. So Mail comes out. So from Thursday from Thursday to Monday, we have 4 days. You have 3 days. You have 3 days in between, which means that that year is 354 days. That's 354 days. So from Shabbos to Tuesday, you have 2 days. Mashenkin, from Thursday to Monday, you have 3 days. And if you would have from Monday to Shabbos, let's say Rosh Hashanah would be Monday 1 year. And the following, so then you would have Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And that year would end up being 355 days. That's the Cheshbon. That's what he's going to say in Halacha Zayin. Halacha Zayin. Derech Yediyas Hashona Im Chadoshah Mlei Mechseidim Ekesidim Lufi Cheshbon Zer Kachu Teide Tchila Yeim Shenigbe Rosh Hashanah Shetirtza Leida Sida Chidusha K'mi Shebiyana V'Perek Shvi. You want to know, when is Rosh Hashanah? When is Rosh Hashanah going to be this year? This year that we're dealing with. That we're trying to figure out how the months are going to be set up. When is it going to be Rosh Hashanah? How do you know when Rosh Hashanah is going to be? So that we know from Perek Zayin. How do we know in Perek Zayin? Based on what we learned in Perek Vav. So notice we have to know when the Meilad is. Meilad Tishrei of this year. And once we know when the Meilad Tishrei is, so we can understand, depending on when Meilad Tishrei is, when Rosh Hashanah is going to be. Misha B'yana V'Perek Shvi. And then, the next thing you have to know is V'teida, Yeim She'ikav Be Rosh Hashanah Shalachra. You have to know the day when Rosh Hashanah is going to be in the following year. And again, you have to figure out when is the Meilad of the following year Tishrei. And based on that, you'll know when the Rosh Hashanah of that following year. And then utechashiv minyan hayom mishabineim. Then you have to count how many days on between these two Rosh Hashanahs. There's how many days of the week. Chutz miyei makviya shalzu v'shalzu. How many days of the week are there going to be between Rosh Hashanah of this year and the Rosh Hashanah of the next year, besides the days of Rosh Hashanah? Im timtze b'neim shnei yamim. If there's only 2 days, which is the minimum amount that could be between these two Rosh Hashanahs, so mainly you know, yir chotchi hashanach seir, because there's going to be 353 days in that year. If there's only 2 days between this Rosh Hashanah and that Rosh Hashanah, means there's 353 days in that year. Im timtze b'neim shleishi yamim. If there's three days, so then you know that there's 354 days in that year, is Yom Kisidon. Then the Chadosh Magim B'Kisidon. Im Timtze B'nei Marbo Yomim, is Yamud Yom Chodshi Hashem Shleimim. So then it'll be Shleimim, because there'll be 355 years, days. Hamedvar Mamurim, when we're talking about Shatir Tzaleida Sida Chodesha, Shatir Tzaleida Sida Chadosh, B'Shehoisa Hashana Shatir Tzaleida Sida Chodesha Pshutim. Masha'engel, if you're talking about Hashanah Mu'beres, Hashanah Mu'beres, you add 30 days. Let's make the cheshbon. You add 30 days. That's the minimum. 30 days you add. Now, 30 days, you already have 30 days. There's 28 days, which are divisible by 7. That's the 4 weeks. And now you have an extra 2 days. So, mele by Hashanah Mu'beres, it was said, Hashanah Pshuta, the minimum between this Rosh Hashanah and that Rosh Hashanah is 2 days. Masha'in, and the maximum is 4 days. Masha'in and Hashanah Mu'beres, the minimum is 4 days. Because Hashanah Mu'beres is a Shana Pshuta of 12 months plus the Shana Mu'beres, which has an extra 2 extra days, which are not Lefi Cheshbon, because there's 30 days, which there's 2 extra days after the 28. So mainly the minimum that there could be between the Rosh Hashanah of the previous year and the Rosh Hashanah of the next year, if the year is a Shana Mu'beres, is 4 days, and the maximum is 6. The maximum is 6. And that means when there's 6 days in between Rosh Hashanah of this year and the Rosh Hashanah of next year, it means that the Rosh Hashanah of next year is the same day like the Rosh Hashanah of this year. That's the Taich. Because we're talking about 6 days besides the 2 days. So it comes out the Rosh Hashanah of next year and the Rosh Hashanah of this year is the same day. That's pshat, that there are 6 days in between this year and next year. Yeah, that could only be after Rosh Hashanah Amu Beres. So now it's the Musig. They should have 1 year, a day of Rosh Hashanah, and the following year should be the same day Rosh Hashanah. Could only be after Rosh Hashanah Amu Beres, and only Rosh Hashanah Amu Beres, which Chadoshah Malayim. So there's a Rosh Hashanah Amu Beres, which has, no, there's just like we're saying, a minimum of Rosh Hashanah Pshuta is 353, and the maximum is 355. So al derech zeh, but again, Hashanah Mu'beres, the minimum is 383, and the maximum is 385. So if you have Hashanah Mu'beres, that's 385 days. So then the following year, Rosh Hashanah is going to end up being the same day like the previous year. Yeah. Nachamol. B'medvar mamur b'shoisa Hashanah shatir tzaleida sida chadushah pshuta. Avol mhoisa Mu'beres. Is as well. Im timtze bein yem kviyosa, bein yem kviya shana shalachra arbo yomim, which is similar to shnei yomim b'nigei apshuta, because over here you added the shana mu'beres, so you have the extra 2 days. So then, yiyo chodshe esa hashana mu'beres chaseirim. So again, it'll be chaseirim. Because that's the minimum amount. It's alderi with 353, but it's over here, it's 383. Because you have the extra shana mu'beres. But legabi the cheshvin and kislev, it makes no difference. Im timtze b'neim chamisha yomim, says yiyo kesidra, which is similar to im timtze b'neim shleisha yom. Im timtze b'neim shisha yoshlem, ketzad. Says, arei sheratzino leida sida chot shishana zu, v'hoi Rosh Hashanah b'chamishi, v'hi pshuta. So you have a year, it's coming a year pshuta, and Rosh Hashanah is on Thursday. And Rosh Hashanah shel achra is b'sheni b'shamas. Rosh Hashanah, next Rosh Hashanah will be Monday. So this Rosh Hashanah is Thursday. Next Rosh Hashanah is going to be Monday. Is nimtza b'neim shleishi yom. So it comes out that this Rosh Hashanah is Thursday. Next Rosh Hashanah is Monday. So there's Friday, Shabbos, and Sunday. Is yodayin Rosh Hashanah zu chadashah kesidah. So memela, since we know there are 3 days in between, and the cheshbon is pashut, that if there's 3 days in between, chapters, that there's 354 days in the year. That's the cheshbon. The 3 days in between means there's 354 days in that year. So then chadusha kesidim. V'ilu hayu Rosh Hashanah shel achreya b'shlishi, not on Monday but on Tuesday. So then hayu chatz shana zushleimo. Then there would be 5 days. Then there would be 4 days. I mean, 4 days in between the first Rosh Hashanah and second Rosh Hashanah. V'ilu hayu Rosh Hashanah b'shana zu b'shabbos u'b'shana shel achreya b'shlishi b'shabbos. So you have from Shabbos to Tuesday. So then is again hayu chatz shana zu seiru. Because Shabbos, from Shabbos to Tuesday, the only thing that's in between is the Sunday and the Monday. But by Shana Muberes, it's a question of 4 days or 5 days or 6 days. So, Nachamal, the Cheshbon is Pasha. If you have, in other words, you want to know how to set up the months, if the months are Chseirim or they're Malayim or they're Ksidra. So basically, it depends. Is the year a year that has 353 days? Does the year have 354 days? Or does the year have 355 days? Now, basically, it means from one Rosh Hashanah to Rosh Hashanah, how many days are there going to be? Now, how do you make the cheshbon how many days there are? So you see, what's the difference in the days of the week between this Rosh Hashanah and next Rosh Hashanah? If there's 2 days, not including the two Rosh Hashanahs, it means that the year has 353 days, so it's chaserim. If there's 4 days, so not including the Rosh Hashanah and Rosh Hashanah, so memela, so it means that the year has 355 days, and memela, so then malayim. And if there's 3 days, so then, so it's kesidim. That's the cheshbon. It's the cheshbon pasul. By muberes, the question is it 4 days, 5 days, or 6 days? Halacha Yud. Yesh sham simonim shetismech aleim kele shalitita b'cheshbon sidr chodshi hashana. But there are some simonim which are simple simonim. Mele, you won't have to make any cheshbenis. V'heim b'nuyim al ikri zeh acheshbon and v'hakviyes v'hatchiyes shebiyarnu darko. They're also based on this cheshbon and also the kviyos and tchiyes shebiyarnu darko. I'm not sure. I mean, we learned about the kviyas and the tchiyas that you push off from Adu or various different, you know, the four rules that we learned in Perek Zayin. Maybe we'll see how that's negeya hertzu. Ve'eluhem. So he's telling you rules. Kol shana sheyir Rosh Hashanah b'bishlishi is tia le'elam kesidron l'fi cheshbon zeh bein pshute bein muberes. So the first rule is that if you have a year which the Rosh Hashanah is on Tuesday, so you could know Pashtos that the Chadasha is going to be Kesidra. It's not going to be Chseirim, and it's not going to be Malayim. And the Cheshbon is Pashut, because if, we learned already, that in order for it to be Kesidra, it means there's 3 days in between Rosh Hashanah of this year, Rosh Hashanah of next year. Chseirim means there's only 2 days, and Malayim means there are 4 days. That's when we're talking about in Hashanah Pshuta. So now you have Rosh Hashanah on Tuesday. Rosh Hashanah was on Tuesday. So in order for this year to be Chadoshah Chseirim, means there's 2 days in between Rosh Hashanah of this year and Rosh Hashanah of next year. Now in order for there to be 2 days between Rosh Hashanah of this year and Rosh Hashanah of next year, if Rosh Hashanah this year is Tuesday, it would mean Rosh Hashanah of next year would be Friday. And that's Friday, that's Pashto says, we have to know the Kviyas and the Tchiyas. Friday can't be Rosh Hashanah. So since Friday can't be Rosh Hashanah, so Mela, obviously, so you can't have a year, you can't have that this year is Chadoshah Chseirim, because it would be Chadoshah Chseirim, it would mean that Friday is Rosh Hashanah. That's number one. On the other end, if you want the Chadoshah Shemulayim, so there has to be 4 days. So how would it be 4 days? 4 days would be if Rosh Hashanah the following year would be Sunday. So then there would be Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Shabbos. And we know again that Rosh Hashanah can be Sunday. Can be Friday, can be Sunday. So the only time it could be is Shabbos. Mele, since the only time it could be is Shabbos, and then Mele, we know that Chadashah is going to be Kesidra. It's Pasha. So Nachamal, if it's Hashanah Pshuta, and Rosh Hashanah is on Tuesday, we know Chadashah is Kesidra. Now what happens if it's Hashanah Mu'uberes? So Hashana Muberes, it's either 4 days is the minimum and 6 days is the maximum. So Lechura, you can't have 4 days, as we said, because 4 days would mean that it would be Sunday. It would be Sunday. Notice, in order for there to be only 4 days in between Rosh Hashanah of this Shana Muberes and the next year Rosh Hashanah, so that means Rosh Hashanah would be on Sunday. Sunday it can't be Rosh Hashanah, so it can't be Muberes. But it could be on Monday. Now, if it's Monday, so it's 5 days. So Hashana Muberes, that there's 5 days in between the Rosh Hashanah and the next year Rosh Hashanah. So again, so Tuesday is Rosh Hashanah. So you have Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Shabbos, Sunday. And on Monday is the next year Rosh Hashanah. So Mela comes out that this year Shana Muberes is Chadoshah Kisidro. That's the Pashtuzach. The question is, L'chura, it could also be on Tuesday. And if it'll be on Tuesday, so then it'll be Chadoshah Malayim. So why can't we have that Rosh Hashanah of the previous year should be Tuesday? And it's a Shana Muberes. So Shana Muberes, the maximum you can have is 6 days. So the following year, again, it should be Tuesday. It should be Tuesday. And then it'll be Chadoshah Malayim. And the Rambam is saying not like that. The Rambam is saying that if Rosh Hashanah is Bishlishi, it'll be Le'elam Kisidon Lufi Cheshmezeh, Bein Pshuta Bein Muberes. So on that, the beer is, because Lepeil Mamish, if Rosh Hashanah came out on Tuesday, so how did Rosh Hashanah come out on Tuesday? The only way Rosh Hashanah could come out on Tuesday is if the Moilad of Tishrei was somewhere in between midday on Chatzeis on Monday, the Chatzeis of the Monday, until Mamish right before Chatzeis on Tuesday. In other words, if it would have been before Chatzeis on Monday, so it would have been on Monday Rosh Hashanah. It would have been Rosh Hashanah would have been on Monday. In order for Rosh Hashanah to be on Tuesday, Moilad Tishrei had to be between the hours of Chatzeis on Monday and the right before Chatzeis on Tuesday. The only that. That's the only way that it could be Rosh Hashanah fall out on Tuesday. In other days, Lamashal, for Rosh Hashanah to fall out on Monday, it could have been that the Moilad was on Sunday. It could have been early on Sunday, because Le'adu, it could have been even Shabbos afternoon. Because it doesn't have to be Dafke then, because there could have been a Dichoy. But Tuesday comes after Monday. So from Monday to Tuesday, there's no Dichoy. So the only way that Rosh Hashanah should be on Tuesday is only if the Moilad Tishrei was on Monday from Chatzeis until the one Chelik before Chatzeis on Tuesday. That's the rule. Now, when would next year Tishrei Moilad be? When would next year's Tishrei Moilad be? Next year's Tishrei's Moilad would be 5 days and 21 hours and the amount of Chalokim, Reish Dalet Chalokim, following. So the Moilad is going to come out that technically it's not possible that Tishrei, that Rosh Hashanah this year should fall out on Tuesday. And next year, in Hashanah Muberes, again, Tishrei should fall out on Tuesday. Because the difference between it's a technical reason. It's a davar ha-pasha that if Rosh Hashanah falls out on Tuesday, so there's not going to be Rosh Hashanah, even if it's Hashanah Muberes, the following year Tuesday. If Rosh Hashanah falls out on Shabbos, Hashanah Muberes, so it's possible that the next year also Rosh Hashanah should fall out on Shabbos. And al derev ze, other days, if Rosh Hashanah falls out on Thursday, so it's also possible that Rosh Hashanah the following year should fall out on Thursday. Masha'inkin, if Rosh Hashanah falls out on Tuesday, so it's not possible that the Rosh Hashanah of the following year, if even it's Hashanah Muberes, should fall out on Tuesday. So Memele, that's what he's saying again, without getting involved in the cheshbenis. So kol shana sheyir Rosh Hashanah ba b'shlishi tia le'elam kesidra l'fi cheshmezeh bein pshuta bein muberes. It'll always be kesidra, and Memele, so knows if it's a pshuta, so Rosh Hashanah is going to be on Shabbos. The following year, Rosh Hashanah is going to be on Shabbos. It can't be on a Friday, and it can't be on Sunday. And if it's going to be a muberes, so then the Rosh Hashanah of the following year is going to be on Monday. It can't be on Sunday because it can't Le'adu Reish. And it also can't be on Tuesday because technically it can't be on Tuesday. Because lepel, if it fell out on Tuesday this year, so late the cheshbon of the melad is going to make that it's going to fall out on Monday the following year. That's if it fell out on Tuesday. Im yir Rosh Hashanah b'Shabbos b'Sheni is again leitia kisidra leilom bein b'pshuta bein mulberes. If Rosh Hashanah falls out on Shabbos, so it'll again never faket. Im yir Rosh Hashanah b'Shabbos b'Sheni leitia kisidra leilom bein b'pshuta bein mulberes. It'll definitely not be kisidra, because in order for it to be kisidra by pshuta, there has to be 3 days in between. Now, how could there be 3 days in between? If it would fall out on Wednesday, so there would be 3 days in between. It would fall out, if it falls out on Wednesday, it'll be 3 days in between. It'll be, because there's Shabbos, it fell out on Shabbos, and the other Rosh Hashanah fell out on Wednesday, so there's Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. But Le'adur Reish, Rosh Hashanah can't fall out on Wednesday. So Melech comes out, so the following year Rosh Hashanah is either going to be on Tuesday, so then there'll be 2 days in between, and then it'll be a chaser, or it'll fall out on Thursday, and then there'll be 4 days in between, and then it'll be a molly. That's if it's a pshuta. And al that is if it's a muberes, if it fell out on Shabbos. So if it's going to, so if it's a shana muberes, so in order for it to be, in order for it to be kisidron, it would have to be 5 days. 5 days would mean that if it would fall out on Friday, let's say it fell out on Shabbos, and the next year falls out on Friday, so then there's 5 days, there's Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. But it can't fall out on Friday. So it could fall out either on Thursday, so then there's 4 days in between, or it could fall out on Shabbos, so then there are 6 days in between. But I'll call upon, that's the rule. The rule is, Im-Yir, Rosh Hashanah, B'Shabbos, E-B'Sheni. E-B'Sheni as well. Is Leitia, Kisidra, Le'ela, Ben B'Pshuta, Ben Mu'ber. So we made the Cheshbon of Shabbos. Al-Der is a B'Sheni. It can never be Kisidra. Because in order for it to be kisidron by a pshuta, it has to be 3 days in between. So from Monday, let's say, from Monday, it would have to be Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, it would have to fall out on Friday. And it can't fall out on Friday. So it'll either fall out on Thursday or it'll fall out on Shabbos. If we're dealing with a mu'beres, so in order for it to be kisidron, it would have to be 5 days. 5 days would mean that it would fall out on Sunday. In other words, it'd fall out on Sunday. And that can be, because if it started on Monday, so in order for it to be 5 days in between this year Rosh Hashanah and next year Rosh Hashanah, Bamu Beres, there has to be 5 days in between. So if it's, so that would be Sunday, and that can't be. So therefore, it'll either be Shabbos, so it'll be Chaser, or it'll be on Monday, which it'll be Mu Beres, and Monday it could fall out. In year Rosh Hashanah b'Chamishi, if Rosh Hashanah falls out on Chamishi, is im pshutihi, if it's a pshuta, is the efshe shiyeh chadashech selim. Because in order for chadashech selim, it would need that Rosh Hashanah should fall out the next year on Sunday. The fi cheshbon zeh. The im mu'beresi, and if it's mu'beres, he efshe shiyeh chadashech kesidram, because in order for chadashech kesidram, it would have to be 5 days. And 5 days would mean that it would fall out on Wednesday the following week. So maybe it doesn't work out. So Bikitzer is telling you a cheshbon. So the nekudas cheshbon is that we have to know, is this year going to be 353 days, 354 days, or 355 days? And that'll decide if it's Seirim, Sidron, or Malayim. And Alderaz, if it's a Shana Muberes, you have to figure out if it's 383 days, 384 days, or 385 days. And how do you know that? The simple way of knowing it is to see how many days is in between this year's Rosh Hashanah, next year's Rosh Hashanah. And in the Rosh Hashanah Pshuta, if it's 2 days, so it's 383 days. If it's 3 days, so it's 353 days. And if it's 2 days, it's 353. And if it's 3 days, it's 354. And if it's 4 days, it's 355. And that'll decide. And by Mu'beres, if the question is it 4 days, 5 days, and 6 days? And then we have those kviyosin when we know when it can't be, how many days it could be. So if it's L'Marshal on Tuesday, so we know that if it falls out on Tuesday, we know that it's going to be Kisidra. That's what we know, whether it's a Mu'beres or a Pshuta. And Al-Dal is there, the other Cheshbenus. There's Rosh Hashanah is B'Shabbos, so a B'Sheni, it'll never be Kisidra. It'll never be Kisidra. Name b'pshuta beimu beres, because it can't be 3 days in between, or it can't be 5 days in between. That's the cheshbonos.